Ward Kimball.
Ward Kimball was the only person that Walt ever told publicly that he was a genius. He never would do that. He always did it across the board, by all my geniuses. But in Ward's case, he actually said, Ward Kimball is a genius, which was very, very special for Ward. Ward had many facets. And one of the facets that he had that, of course, I can't thank him enough for was that he's the one that talked Walt into hiring me to go from animation into WED. So that's a whole little story all in itself. One of the best stories of all about Ward is the Firehouse 5 Plus 2. Again, getting back to the fact that we were one great big happy family over there. Ward put together a little group, little Dixieland group, with all the other guys that worked at the studio. George Probert played soprano sax in the Firehouse 5, and George was really, truly the only real Dixieland musician in the group that had been a professional Dixieland player. In fact, he actually had played with Kid Ory. Kid Ory was the band that he played with. And he had to be almost a teenager to play with Kid Ory, because Kid Ory was very popular in the 20s. Now, the other one was Danny Elguar. He played trumpet, and he was an editor in the from a music editor. Then there was Frank Thomas, played the piano. And so Ward put this whole little crazy group of guys together and created this Firehouse 5 Plus 2. And the way it got the name Firehouse 5 Plus 2 was originally, it was just called the Firehouse 5, because that's all there was. But then they used to get a lot of gigs and played all over, you know, down in Hollywood and groups and stuff. Well, Ward added a couple more guys to the band. And when it was given to the fellow that was putting him on stage, the fellow said, what's the name of your group? And he said, the Firehouse 5. He says, yeah, but there's two more guys in there. He says, it's a Firehouse 5 Plus 2. So he made it up as he went, and they became extremely popular. And one of the best things about it was they went out and bought an old antique fire engine, and they actually, all of them piled up in the fire engine and drove to San Diego, because they used to give shows all over the place. Well, the neat thing about it was you could go over in the soundstage a couple nights, days a week at lunchtime and listen to them practice. So it was a delight. And I think Walt just loved the idea that Ward had the Firehouse 5, because it always became a very, very popular Dixieland group. And Ward went out of his way to find some of the real old musicians, and he'd invite them out to his house on a Sunday and get them all together, because he wanted the Firehouse 5 to really sound like what they used to sound like in the very beginning and what they did as entertainment. Because, as Ward put it, it wasn't just music. The guys get up there and they'd entertain. They'd shuffle and dance, and they'd do all kinds of crazy stuff. So Ward was really really into making sure that the Firehouse 5 was really like what a Dixieland band was. And then they did very, very well. And it was very popular albums he made. And it was just great.